Good morning, and welcome to our first live streamed school mass. Today I'm with Father Scott, our pastor. Mr. Bevan is here as a lector. His wife Debbie is playing the piano today, and Mrs. Freeman is filming this. So we hope that you all are in a comfortable spot, that you have the music printed out, and you'll be able to participate in this mass much like you do at a school mass any other day. Today is the last week of Lent. So as we begin, let's start with our gathering song, Here I Am, Lord.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the
fellowship and strength of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we gather this day to give God thanks and praise, we begin by admitting that we are sinners. For the times we've sinned, let us ask now for God's forgiveness and mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Be near, O Lord, to those who plead before you, and look kindly on those who place their hope in your mercy, that, cleansed from the stain of their sins, they may persevere in holy living and be made full heirs of your promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. When Abram prostrated himself, God spoke to him. My covenant with you is this. You are to become the father of a host of nations. No longer shall you be called Abram. Your name shall be Abraham. For I am making you the father of a host of nations. I will render you exceedingly fertile. I will make nations of you. Kings shall stem from you. I will maintain my covenant with you and your descendants after you throughout the ages as an everlasting pact to be your God and the God of your descendants after you. I will give to you and to your descendants after you the land in which you are now staying, the whole land of Canaan, as a permanent possession. And I will be their God. God also said to Abraham, on your part, you and your descendants after you must keep my covenant throughout the ages. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my
Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever keeps my word will never see death. So the Jews said to him, now we are sure that you are possessed. Abraham died, as did the prophets. Yet you say, whoever keeps my word will never taste death. Are you greater than our father Abraham who died, or the prophets who died? Who do you make yourself out to be? Jesus answered, if I glorify myself, my glory is worth nothing. But it is my Father who glorifies me, of whom you say, he is our God. You do not know him, but I know him. And if I should say that I do not know him, I would be, like you, a liar. But I do know him, and I keep his word. Abraham, your father, rejoiced to see my day. He saw it and was glad. So the Jews said to him, you are not yet 50 years old, and you have seen Abraham? Jesus said to them, amen, amen, I say to you, before Abraham came to be, I am. So they picked up stones to throw at him, but Jesus hid and went out of the temple area. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, here we are, the fifth week of the great season of Lent. And we have some beautiful scriptures before us today. And the one common theme is Abraham. And Abraham was a person of great faith. He trusted in what God said to him and was faithful follower of that word. Abraham would trust God's goodness, leave everything behind, and go to a distant land. He would even change his name because he trusted in God. And it's a beautiful, faithful example of what you and I are called to be about during the season of Lent. You know, I had to ask for a dollar bill before we started our school mass today. And there are some interesting words on the stuff that we call money. And all it is a piece of paper that's printed up and colored and all this. And we put a lot of faith in this kind of stuff. But there are a couple words on the back that I want us to focus on, especially in light of Abraham. And it's this: in God we trust. Over the last couple of weeks, I'm one of those that loves to watch the stock market, and I've watched it kind of take a nosedive. And I go back to these words that are printed on the back of the dollar bill. In God we trust. This is just paper, and we put a lot of faith in paper. But Abraham put his faith where it counted the most, in God. And God called him out of a familiar way of life,
And Abraham trusted that God would remain faithful to him, left it all behind, left his family, left everything that he knew, and faithfully went to where God asked him to go. And I think God is challenging you and me today to do the same thing, to go somewhere maybe we don't want to go. I mean, it's a new reality, a new thing, a new way of doing things. We find ourselves today in that situation. But we're called to be with family. We're called to study at home. We're called to reach out to others on the phone and check on them. We're called to maybe knock on someone's door and leave a care package and leave them alone. But we're called to trust first in God. There's a lot of funny things going on in the world today. And I do mean that funny, that bring us some smiles and some laughter. I was in the grocery store the other day and I saw a t-shirt that read, "In Andy We Trust." That's our governor. So go back to the green stuff. In God we trust. During the season of Lent, what is God asking of you and I? What is he asking us to give up? What are the challenges we might face? But what is the blessing that we will receive in the end? We're called to remain faithful as Abraham was faithful. And God will be true to his promises to us. Please stand. We've listened to God's word today, and we turn as a people of faith, trusting that God will hear and respond. Let us today pray for all of our families, those who support us, those who love us, our grandparents, our aunts and uncles, our parents, our brothers and sisters, all those who have shown us goodness through our lives, that we may return the favor manyfold. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for government leaders. Let us pray that God's wisdom and mercy may be foremost in their decision making. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the church, the many members that make it up, that they may show God's goodness and remain faithful to the promises God has made to us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember the sick, the homebound, the shut-in, especially those in nursing homes and hospitals. Let us pray in a special way for caregivers, first responders, for all those who put their lives on the line. Let us pray for their safety and their well-being. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us continue to pray for those who have asked for our prayers this day, for the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, and for the intention of today's Mass. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of glory and majesty, we give you thanks and praise and humbly ask that you hear and grant the petitions we set before you. We seek the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary and ask that you hear us in your spirit. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on these sacrificial offerings, that they may profit our conversion and the salvation of all the world. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess with infinite power your majesty, since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed, and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, and it's in exaltation we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And since all of you are at home, please exchange with each other the sign of Christ's peace. Sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join us now as we sing Be Not Afraid.
Before our final blessing, if you have a birthday in the great month of March, would you please stand at home? Loving God, you created all the people of the world, and you knew each of us before we were born. We thank you for our friends who have celebrated their birthday this month. Bless them with your love and help each of them grow in wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Help them love their families and be grateful for their friends and to know how special they are in your eyes today and every day. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
So happy birthday to all of the March birthdays. And let us pray. Be gracious to your people, Lord, we pray, that as from day to day, they reject what does not please you, they may be filled instead with delight at your commands. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Our closing song is Jerusalem, My Destiny.